holidays are the perfect time to pull out all the stops in the kitchen. And that's what we're doing. Who better for us to kick off the Christmas season with than the Iron Chef herself, our very good friend, Chef Kat Cora.
Welcome back.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
This is amazing.
Look what you've done for us. We're so impressed. Well, Pam, Kim, Larissa, you guys dig in.
Yeah, dig in.
So that beautiful plate in front of you. So you were making us something very special that you love to make for special occasions.
I love to make Cornish hens. And, you know, people think that's so fancy. I can't afford to do Cornish hen, but they're only about $3 or $4 a piece in your local grocery store. And they're really not expensive. They just seem fancy because I guess they're little individual chickens. Little baby chickens.
Cornish hens.
Cornish hens.
They sound fancy. And basically, it's just a little chicken.
It's just a baby chicken. It's just a style of small chicken.
Okay.
That's actually perfect because it works for individuals, especially for dinner parties, holiday parties, things like that. And it tastes just like chicken. So, because it is a chicken.
Because it is a chicken.
Because it is a chicken.
You baste it with pomegranate and you stuff it with wild rice.
Because I think this is definitely holiday when you have roasted chestnuts. I mean, we all think of the holidays, roasted chestnuts. And so I think with herbs and a little onion in there. So I've got thyme, parsley, some roasted chestnuts, and I made this wild rice.
Okay.
And this actually becomes a stuffing. So you're not having a bread stuffing, you're having a rice stuffing, which I actually like sometimes to change it up. Mix that up sometimes.
I agree.
That's what I'm going to do with this. And then I've roasted these, add a little bit of the parsley in, add some thyme.
Now, roasted chestnuts can sort of be a situation. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, I've roasted chestnuts many times. I'll tell you what. When you try to open those chestnuts,
you're
bleeding. They'll
yeah,
hurt.
It's really tough. But nowadays in your grocery stores, they have jarred chestnuts, or you can find the jarred that are already peeled. They're already roasted. Or if they're not roasted, you just put them in an oven for at 325, roast them for, you know, 8 to 10 minutes, and then you have the roasted chestnuts.
Without the shells.
Without all that work. But
that would be good to eat on its own.
Well, it is. And I actually make extra. So I stuff the Cornish hens, which we're going to do right now.
Okay.
Stuff the Cornish hens. And then I make a side dish with some of the extra rice. So just make a side dish and a casserole. Pop that in the oven about 25 minutes before the Cornish hens are ready. And there you have a side dish as well.
Kat, I got to say this.
Yeah,
this skin is perfectly crispy.
Isn't that nice?
And you'll find out why in just a second.
Okay.
You're about to find
so
out.
Good.
So what we're going to do first is we're going to just truss this little baby. So what I'm going to do is
we're going to truss him before we stuff him?
No, I mean stuff him and truss him. Stuff him and truss him.
Stuff and truss.
Stuff and truss. And you don't want to stuff too much in here. You want to let, because the rice will expand with the juices. So you want to make sure you don't overstuff it.
Okay.
Just enough. And then what I've done here is we have a classically trussed little bird here where you just take it. It's very classic. You wrap it around the two legs and then around the wings. It can be a little bit more complicated, but it is a classic way of doing it. The reason you truss is so that the chicken, when it's cooked, because it'll kind of open up, you want it to be this tight little gorgeous presentation like you see here.
Right,
I mean,
there.
You see that beautiful little presentation. I'm going to show you an even easier way.
And it cooks more evenly when it's trussed, doesn't
it? Right, exactly. Okay. It cooks a little more evenly as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to basically tie these little babies up here. Just tie the little legs.
It just looks so fancy.
It does.
Yeah, it does, but it's not. And then you can just tie it and then get that ready to go. And then what you can do now, so you've got the legs together, then you can take toothpicks on each side and then just stick the wings right in like that. Very, very easy. This is just a secondary way of doing the trussing if you don't want it to be as complicated, or maybe you just can't end up figuring it out, because we can all tie our shoes. We've been doing that for a long time. We haven't been trussing for a long time. And then a little bit of salt and pepper all over. I like to put a little bit on, just spread it over evenly. Little bit of salt on there.
Okay.
There you go. And then we pop this in a 375 degree oven.
That guy right there. You want to put her in before we take
I am going to put that in right here.
There you go.
Put this in 375 degree oven. This is going to be about 55 minutes for the Cornish hen.
But as it's cooking, you also continue to baste.
You continue to baste
in order to make that skin so crispy and delicious.
That's the secret.
There you go.
Look at this. Woo. You see that skin? That's what I was talking about.
That is what you do. So what you do is every 15, 20 minutes, like you said, we baste with the pomegranate juice. So you're just taking it basically, and you're basting the juice right on top of the Cornish hen. And it just gets really crunchy and crispy and glazy and yummy.
It's amazing.
It's sticky, and we love that flavor, right, when you're having that.
And in the meantime, while all that's happening in the oven, you also make a gravy with with all the little bits and bobs inside of the
all the bits and bobs, and all the stuff. You're going to take the pan. So once you've taken the pan out, you're going to take the pan, you're going to lift that off, And then what you're going to do is you're going to just take these right off here. I'm going to put that there for a sec. And then you have all of this gravy juice, all these pan juices. You put it on top of the stove. And then you just put some stock in. You start kind of getting all those scraps from the bottom, all those pieces, because that's what makes the flavor. That's the richness of a gravy, right? Wow. And then you have this beautiful, beautiful gravy.
All right, Captain.
All right, so let's
talk about some of your holiday traditions as you're plating this for us. What are some of your favorites?
One of the things we love to do is we love to have matching pajamas. All of us together, we put on matching pajamas, and we actually do that. That's the one gift we open on Christmas Eve, because we open our Christmas gifts on Christmas Day. But we do that before on Christmas Eve. We all wearing our matching pajamas. We love to do a big crab dinner. And then we also celebrate Hanukkah and Christmas.
Good
so we do
Christmaka.
Christmaka. We are definitely one of these that we love. We love the family traditions of doing Hanukkah and Christmas. Now, what you want to do is you want to make sure, do we still have those scissors
there
here?
There you go.
You want to make sure you snip off that twine. Don't eat that. Make sure that comes off. Definitely take that off before you serve it to your guests and your family. So
and
take off that string.
Like
and toothpicks. So you're going to just make this a beautiful little pile here of rice. Then you're going to nappe this gravy right over the top.
Should
look
I
at that.
Some of these pomegranate,
pomegranate seeds.
What was
which
that
are so
yeah,
healthy.
Nappe?
Nappe.
Is that like
nap?
Nap it. It's nappe. It just means to like give it a little glaze on top. There you go.
I like that.
Oh, I love that.
Spin that too. Go on. Do you need a
Let's go, baby. Let's go. I love it. I love it.
Can we see how beautiful that
was? How was it? How was it?
I know.
Use your fingers.
Oh my gosh. You guys can have a little taste.
Holidays.
We've already been eating. We've got extras. Life is good here.
Look at
to
that.
Kick off
that
countdown to Christmas, everybody. You'll find this recipe at HallmarkChannel.com.